I'm gonna praise the Lord. Every morning, noon, and night, I'm gonna praise the Lord. I'm gonna praise the Lord. I'm gonna praise the Lord. When I stop to eat my lunch, bow my head and I pray. I'm gonna praise the Lord. Every morning, noon, and night, I'm gonna praise the Lord. I'm gonna praise the Lord.
Hello and welcome to the Pastor Jack Triple Hour with Pastor Jack and Linda Gale, bringing you some of the finest gospel music this side of heaven, with words of our Lord's wisdom to live by. Pastor Jack and Linda Gale, under the leadership of our Lord Jesus Christ, are managers of KOTG, KBAF, and Bayou Gospel Radio, all part of the WOTG Radio and TV network. They also transmit on See the Vision Radio. Did you know, in Christ, you can find peace in the midst of the storm? Jesus said in John 14:27, "Peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you. Not as the world gives do I give to you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid." We invite you to be an active part of this God-led ministry by sharing and telling others about this program and our Lord Jesus Christ, of whom they serve. Now here is Pastor Jack and Linda Gale.
Hey, good morning, and welcome to KOTG, WOTG Radio Network, and the WOTG TV Network, where Chuck Bryant is the founder, the general manager, and Jesus Christ is the owner and the CEO, and he will tell you exactly the same thing, because it's all about Jesus. And if it's not about Jesus, then it ain't about nothing. And how many want to hear about Jesus? He's the Lord of Lords and the King of Kings. Praise his holy name. Well, welcome to the Captain Jack Show, Argmady. We're getting ready to sail out into the spiritual realm. So grab your favorite beverage, your favorite snack, come on aboard. And let's get busy, get on out there into the spiritual realm and hear what God has to say. Every song, every word, every prayer speaks to us. So are we listening? Open our ears and amen. Get blessed. God wants to bless you today. He wants to increase you. He wants to encourage you. He wants you to wants to lift you up and cause you to sit in high places. So let's go ahead and get this started. Amen. And we're going to start with Lizzie G. And God's going to wake America.
See some good, clean shows on TV. Now even the commercials ain't fit for a family. Wrong is right and right is now wrong. They tell them apart before too long. The concept of good and bad is distorted. See it all the time in the news they report it. The world is blind as blind can be. The worst thing is they don't wanna see. The truth is everywhere, but we just didn't know it. Hell is full people crying out for one more chance to be saved. While this world is laughing and playing and boozing and living wrong every day. Free speech, they have the right to blaspheme more than put profanity on your car or truck. Where in the world have morals gone? God is gone with America. Abortion took the place of responsibility. The media now condones filthy sexuality. The world tries to pass it off as just fine, but God's gonna set it right anytime. Judgment is gonna fall on a world that's turned away. We're all gonna stand before God one day. I'd rather know that my soul is alright, lay down in peace and sleep at night, then lay awake in fear for the price I might have to pay. Hell is full of people crying out for one more chance to be saved. While this world is laughing and playing and boozing and living wrong every day. Free speech and the right to blaspheme more, put profanity on your car or truck. Where in the world have morals gone? God is gone with America. Sad to see the ungodliness and moral degradation. Evidence that the conscience is in deterioration. Common sense went on vacation. Free speech and the right to blaspheme more, put profanity on your car or truck. Where in the world have morals gone? God is gone with America. God is gone with America.
This is News in 60 with Alan Edwards.
A woman checked out of a Florida hotel and told staff that she was going on a God-directed shooting spree because of the solar eclipse.
22-year-old Talon Nichelle Celestine of Georgia shot two drivers on Interstate 10 before being arrested and charged with attempted murder Monday.
Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu announced there is a date for Israeli defense forces to invade Rafah.
This is a move the United States opposes.
Federal charges have been filed against a 35-year-old man who allegedly set fire to the door of Senator Bernie Sanders' office in Burlington, Vermont.
Shant Sagamonian, formerly of Northridge, California, was arrested after investigators reviewed surveillance camera footage.
A suburban Detroit police officer who punched a young black man in the face and slammed his head to the ground pleaded guilty Monday to a federal civil rights violation.
Matthew Rodriguez acknowledged using unreasonable force against the 19-year-old man while processing him in the fingerprint room at the Warren Jail in June.
This train is bound for glory.
Oh, oh, oh.
We're shouting and singing and telling a story, calling all Christians and calling on His name.
This train is leaving the station,
and your ticket is your salvation.
Oh, 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 oh.
Well, come on, all you Christians, hop aboard this gospel train. For Jesus is the conductor, and we're the reason that He came. Spread the word, tell your brothers and sisters, the next stop is Glory Road. He's firing up the engine, you can hear that whistle blow.
This train is bound for glory. We're shouting and singing and telling the story, calling all Christians and calling on His name.
This train is leaving the station,
and your ticket is your salvation.
All aboard.
Listen to me, sinners, this train's moving down the line. You better act in faith, get your soul saved, or you won't make it in time. It's picking up speed, so give your heart to the Lord. This is the final call, come one and all aboard.
All aboard.
This train is bound for glory.
All aboard.
We're shouting and singing and telling the story, calling all Christians and calling on His name.
This train is leaving the station,
and your ticket is your salvation.
This train is bound for glory. All aboard.
We're shouting and singing and telling a story, calling all Christians and calling on His name.
This train is leaving the station,
and your ticket is your salvation. All aboard.
Got a song I'd like to sing to each of y'all. If anyone's listening, you're welcome to sing along. Now don't be shy, just step up to the mic and pretend it's a karaoke night. Cause it's time to sing the good news and put on your dancing shoes. Oh, Jesus came to bring us life when He rose up from the grave. That's right. I am here to testify He's still alive today. Oh, Jesus is the solid rock on which my faith will stand. No matter what is going on, gonna put it in His hands. Oh, Jesus is my living hope, and I never will deny that Jesus is my one true friend, and I'm here to testify. Oh, can I get a witness who will say amen and testify that you've been born again? Now don't be shy, just step up to the mic and pretend it's a karaoke night, cause it's time to sing of the good news and put on your dancing shoes. Jesus came to bring us life when he rose up from the grave. That's right. I am here to testify he's still alive today. Oh, Jesus is the solid rock on which my faith will stand. No matter what is going on, I'm gonna put it in his hands. Oh, Jesus is my living hope, and I never will deny that Jesus is my one true friend, and I'm here to testify. Oh, Jesus is my one true friend, and I'm here to testify. Yes, Jesus is my one true friend, and I'm here to testify.
Thank you.
Oh, who are weary? Lay down your burdens, and he will give you rest. Come, all who are wounded, praying for healing from every mess you make. No, he will never turn you away. He does beautiful things with broken pieces, but others abandon, he mends and restores. Wait till you see what he can do with hopeless. You were never meant, no, you were never meant to stay broken. Bring every question, the doubts that have whispered, you'll never be whole again. Bring the fear you've been fighting, the change you've been hiding, all of the same sins and mistakes. Oh, just let Jesus take it away.
Take it away.
He does beautiful things with broken pieces. For others abandon, he mends and restores. Wait till you see what he can do with hopeless. You were never meant, though you were never meant to stay broken. Let it go. Let it go.
Let it go. With broken pieces, what others abandon, he mends and restores. Wait till you see what he can do with hopeless. You were never meant, no, you were never meant to stay broken.
Of all we'll
tread the streets of gold. When Jesus comes in the clouds, there'll be no more goodbyes, no tears dim our eyes. When Jesus comes in the clouds, when Jesus comes in glory bright, we'll eat the lonely scene. All sorrow will be past, the eternal joy at last. When Jesus comes in the clouds, when Jesus comes, when Jesus comes in glory bright, we'll eat the Lord and sing. All sorrow will be past, the eternal joy at last. When Jesus comes in the clouds, all sorrow will be past, the eternal joy at last. When Jesus comes, when Jesus comes in the clouds.
Desert for the land of milk and honey, with nothing but sand in their sights. Moses climbed the mountain to have a chat with God, to verify their path was right. But while he was gone, the party went on, and God was far from their mind. They made a calf of gold, were corrupt and lost their souls. Savior had to set them right. On a lightning bolt, God's word came to life. Chiseled in stone, commandments to live by. He said, I am your God, put nothing before me. Don't use my name in vain, and keys are holy. Honor mom and dad, don't love another's wife, don't covet anything, don't steal, kill, or lie. Times haven't changed, man is still the same, cutting corners on the fast track. Still looking for the gold, will corrupt your soul. You think by now we should realize, on a lightning bolt, God's word came alive. They were chiseled in stone, commandments left by. He said, I am your God, put nothing before me. Don't use my name in vain, and kiss another. Honor mother and dad, don't love another's wife, don't covet anything, don't steal, kill, or lie. He said, I am your God, put nothing before me. Don't use my name in vain, and kiss another. Up and there, don't love another's wife, don't covet anything, don't steal, kill, or
a woman checked out of a Florida hotel and told staff that she was going on a God-directed shooting spree because of the solar eclipse.
22-year-old Talon Nichelle Celestine of Georgia entered the highway 115 miles from the Alabama border in the Florida Panhandle and headed west. She then shot two drivers on Interstate 10 before being arrested and charged with attempted murder Monday, according to the Florida Highway Patrol. Lawrence Keller reporting.
What's up?
provides everything I need. From the old rugged cross to the air that I breathe, is everlasting open wide. I'm saved by his love and washed in the blood. My God provides. Though my heart can't see, I will trust you to lead. Though the water is deep, you'll make a way for me. Through the wind and the rain, my God will make a way. Called me to walk on the waves, I'll take your hand. And I will say, my God provides everything I need. From the old rugged cross to the air that I breathe, is everlasting. Saved by his love and washed in the blood, my God provides. Though my sin meant death, you took it all and paid it yourself. The Lamb of God who was slain in love gave his life away. My God provides everything I need. From the old rugged cross to the air that I breathe, everlasting arms are always open wide. I'm saved by his love and washed in the blood. My God provides. I'm saved by his love and washed in the blood. My God provides. My God provides. My God provides. My God provides.
Locked in prison, I've been bound up tight. Trouble and chains trying to stop my fight. Ain't nobody gonna go my bail. Oh, devil, chain me right outside my cell. I'm not Silas, I'm never be Paul. Found the only way to shake those walls. I didn't make a break in that midnight hour. They sang the house down with that Holy Ghost power. Feel a little song coming on.
Ain't no bars gonna hold me long. Gonna keep on singing till they're gone. These old walls ain't that strong. Feel a little song coming on. Feel a little song coming on. Ain't no bars gonna hold me long. Gonna keep on singing till they're gone. These old walls are not that strong. Feel a little song coming on.
Circumstances got you doing time. Hold your peace until 11:59. Just clear your throat, see you do your thing. Straight up midnight, make the rafters ring. Can't be somber, no, don't be soft. Go right on and sing that roof right off. There's no escape, so the devil says that he's not gotten this rain out of trance.
Feel a little song coming on. Ain't nobody's gonna hold me long. Gonna keep on singing till they're gone. These old walls ain't that strong. Feel a little song coming on. Feel a little song coming on. Ain't no bars gonna hold me long. Gonna keep on singing till they're gone. These old walls are not that strong. I feel a little song coming on.
Gonna let a little powder off these doors. Rumble and roll underneath these floors. Tail out, pray, let Taylor through. Sing out of these prison blues.
Song coming on. Ain't nobody's gonna hold me long. Gonna keep on singing till they're gone. These old walls ain't that strong. I feel a little song coming on. I feel a little song coming on. Ain't nobody's gonna hold me long. Gonna keep on singing till they're gone. These old walls. Song coming on.
Gonna keep on singing till they're gone. These old walls are not that strong.
I feel a little song coming on.
God told Moses, lead my people out, lead them out of Pharaoh's hand. Then they began their journey, they were bound for the promised land. Pharaoh's army right behind, they came up against the Red Sea. Waters were parted, they crossed over, God brought the victory. God has a miracle just for you. All you have to do is believe. Don't give up, keep a holding on. Get ready for the victory. As you journey to the promised land, when the devil comes around, he must leave. God has a miracle just for you. All you have to do is believe. There was a time when Satan had me bound. Trouble came along my way. Everything was going wrong. I was sinking in the miry clay. About to go under when I looked up. I saw God's helping hand. He reached down, he picked me up. Now I'm going to the promised land. God has a miracle just for you. All you have to do is believe. Don't give up, keep a holding on. Get ready for the victory. As you journey to the promised land, when the devil comes around, he must leave. God has a miracle just for you. All you have to do is believe. God has a miracle just for you. All you have to do is believe. Don't give up, keep a holding on. Get ready for the victory. As you journey to the promised land, when the devil comes around, he must leave. God has a miracle just for you. All you have to do is believe. God has a miracle just for you. All you have to do is believe.
Never get too lost that I can't be found. There's no feeling greater. Never get too down that I can't look up and see my Savior. He's my healer. Jesus is my healer. He's my healer. Jesus is my healer. So blessed to know I got a hand to hold whenever I'm falling. It's good to believe when I got a need that I can just call him. He's my healer. Jesus is my healer. He's my healer. Jesus is my healer. The stripes he took, the blood he shed, my heart never will forget how glad I am to have him by my side. Jesus is my healer. Jesus is my healer. He's my healer. Jesus is my healer. He's my healer. Jesus is my healer.
Jesus, you're my healer. I opened my eyes this morning and I stood to my feet and I saw the sun was shining bright. I felt that gentle breeze. I raised my hands toward heaven, and he spared me another day. I know my God is real to me. He will never change. I believe there's a God, because I'm standing He told it to hang there for life, and he hung out the stars to guide the night. Take a look at that big sea. Look at the mountains and the trees. My God created for you and me. He breathed in my nostrils, and he made a living soul. Yes, I believe there's a God. He believes in me. I believe there's a God. Thank you.
Jesus gave his very best. His love was proven for me when he loved me. He took my place on the cross at Calvary. He took my pain in his hands and his feet. Mercy.
Years ago, the devil, he tried to change my course and take another road. Well, devil, move your roadblocks, because I'm coming through.
By the blood of Jesus Christ, that's what I'm gonna do.
Out of my way, you can't stay. Yeah, mountain.
my way.
Hey everyone, this is Tim Thomas with the Southern Plainsman Quartet. You're listening to the very best in Southern gospel music right here on KOTG Radio.
If you see a brother or a sister fall, if you see them going astray, don't condemn them, don't put them down. You'll only drive them further away. Ooh. You've got to love them like to the Lord. That's what they're waiting for. You've got to show them you care. Hold them up in prayer. You've got to love them back to the Lord. Never think you're too good to call yourself a judge. You've only appointed yourself. You better take a look at your own life before you look at somebody else. Ooh. You've got to love them back to the Lord. That's what they're waiting for. You've got to show them you care. Hold them up in prayer. You've got to love them back to the Lord. Only love can reach out in the darkest night and help a soul that has wandered away back into the guiding light. You've got to love them back to the Lord. That's what they're waiting for. You've got to show them you care. Hold them up in prayer. You've got to love them back to the Lord. You've got to love them back to the Lord. That's what they're waiting for. You've got to show them you care. Hold them up in prayer. You've got to love them back to the Lord. You've got to love them back to the
Lord. Strong. Yeah, the face I keep pulling on says I ain't tired, but these tear-stained eyes ain't lying. Cause hard, nobody told me life could be so hard. A weary soul with a worn-out heart that's barely beating. But every time I get that feeling, I hit my knees with my hands held high, saying, dear Lord Jesus, you know do this on my own. Lord knows I've tried, but I'm good at falling down. Thank God you're good at picking me up off the ground. The world's gonna try to break me, but I know the one who makes me strong. Strong, like my daddy always told me so. There's a place you can always go when you got nothing. And then he handed me the one thing.
doesn't matter how old it is. There's power in the words you read in this old Bible. And when I'm desperate for revival, I hit my knees with my hands held high, saying, dear Lord Jesus, you know I can't do this on my own. I can't do this on my own. I hit my knees with my hands held high, saying, dear Lord Jesus, you know I can't do this on my own. I can't do this on my own.
It wasn't him. all to Jesus. I surrender all to Him. I freely give. I will never love, and I'll trust Him in His presence daily. Oh, and I surrender all. Yes, I surrender all to Thee, my blessed Savior. I surrender all. It wasn't Him, but God wanted me. And all this altar where He lay, justified, it wasn't Him, but God wanted me.
This is News in 60 with Alan Edwards.
A woman checked out of a Florida hotel and told staff that she was going on a God-directed shooting spree because of the solar eclipse.
22-year-old Talon Nichelle Celestine of Georgia shot two drivers on Interstate 10 before being arrested and charged with attempted murder Monday.
Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu announced there is a date for Israeli defense forces to invade Rafah.
This is a move the United States opposes.
Federal charges have been filed against a 35-year-old man who allegedly set fire to the door of Senator Bernie Sanders' office in Burlington, Vermont.
Shant Sagamonian, formerly of Northridge, California, was arrested after investigators reviewed surveillance camera footage.
A suburban Detroit police officer who punched a young black man in the face and slammed his head to the ground pleaded guilty Monday to a federal civil rights violation.
Matthew Rodriguez acknowledged using unreasonable force against the 19-year-old man while processing him in the fingerprint room at the Warren Jail in June.
It's okay if it's hard to believe. I have faith that You will do greater things. It's my time to go, but before I leave, go tell the world about Me. I was dead, but now I live. I've gotta go now for a little while. The goodbye is not the end. Don't forget the things that I've taught you. I've conquered death and I hold the keys. Where I go, You will go too someday. There's much to do here before You leave. So go tell the world about Me. I was dead, but now I live. I gotta go now for a little while. The goodbye is not the end of the journey, the end of the road. My spirit is with You wherever You go. You have a purpose.
Go tell the world about me. I was dead, but now I live. I gotta go now for a little while. Your goodbye is not the end. Oh, oh, oh. Go tell them about me. The end.
I am nothing. You are everything. I'm a pauper. You are the king. I am lowly. You are power and might, I'm a sinner. You are holiness and might. You are the healer of my soul, my redeemer, the lovely, the savior in control. You are the strength that holds your people together, Lord, I'm the worst. You are always the better. I am less. You are more. I'm a failure. You are the Lord. I'm so small. You are larger than life, I'm always what's wrong. You are always what's right. You are the healer of my soul, my redeemer, the lovely, the savior in control. You are the strength and hold your people together. Oh, I'm the worst. You are always the better.
Lord,
you are the healer of my soul, my redeemer, the lovely, the savior in control. You are the strength that holds your people together. Lord, I'm the worst. You are always the better. Lord, I'm the worst. You are always the better.
Just a woman. Help me believe in what I could be and all that I am. Show me the stairway that I have to climb. Lord, for my sake, teach me to take one day at a time. Show me the way, one day at a time.
among men. Well, Jesus, you know, when you're looking below, it's worse now than then. Pushing and shoving, grabbing my mind. So for my sake, teach me to take one day at a time. One day at a time, sweet Jesus, that's all I'm asking from you. Give me the strength to do every day what I have to do. Yesterday's gone, sweet Jesus, and tomorrow may never be mine. Help me today, show me the way, one day at a time. Help me today, show me the way, one day at a time. Help me today, show me the way, one day at a
Shepherd who takes good care of me. I've got a good shepherd who takes good care of me. I'm living a life of royalty, 'cause I've got a good shepherd who takes good care of me. Whenever I'm hungry, he gives me food to eat. Whenever I'm thirsty, he gives me water to drink. He's always listening just to hear my plea. I've got a good shepherd who takes good care of me. And this is what he does.
He opens windows of heaven and pours me out his blessing. They keep falling on me. I'm running out of room to receive. His love is higher than high and bigger than the oceans or the sea.
I've got a good shepherd who takes good care of me. Listen. Whenever I'm lonely, he always comforts me. Whenever I'm burdened, he always sets me free. And whom the Son has set free, he's free indeed. Yeah, I've got a good shepherd who takes good care of me.
He opens windows of heaven. He pours me out his blessing.
Yes, he does.
They keep falling on me.
Said I'm running out of room to receive.
His love is higher than I,
and it's deeper than the ocean goes on the sea. I've got a good shepherd, yes, who takes good care of me. Said he opened up the windows of heaven, and he pours me out.
gifts, blessings, they keep falling on me. Said I'm running out of room to receive. His love is higher than high, and it's deeper than the ocean goes on the sea. I've got a good shepherd who wakes me up early in the morning. Said he clothes me in my right mind. We've got a real good shepherd. Yeah, who takes good care of you and me.
Have you been to Jesus for the cleansing power? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? And are your garments spotless? Are they white as snow? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Are you washed in the blood? In the soul cleansing? Would you be free from your burden of sin? There is power in the blood. Oh, there's power in the blood. Would you or evil a victory win? There's wonderful power in the blood. There is power, power, wonder-working power in the blood.
What a blessing. You are listening to Pastor Jack and Linda Gale on KOTG Radio and TV, KBAF, Bayou Gospel, and See the Vision Radio. You will also find us on Facebook Live, Pinterest, and YouTube.
Just where I'd be had Jesus never reached down his hand for me. I'd still be adrift with no hope in sight, but for a wonderful Savior on that dark, lonely night. Rescued me. When I was so far gone as I could ever be, with nowhere.
wants to be free. Jesus' hand rescued me.
Yes, I did.
So aimlessly, dark clouds all around, and unable to see, helplessly lost. My outlook was grim when I called out to Jesus and put my trust in Him.
Rescued me.
I was so far gone
as I could ever be.
No will to live or chance to be free. Jesus' hand rescued me. Jesus' hand rescued me. Jesus' hand rescued me.
Yes, He did. Yes, He did.
Jesus' hand rescued me. I was so far gone
as I could possibly be.
Jesus' hand
rescued me.
Jesus' hand rescued me.
A woman checked out of a Florida hotel and told staff that she was going on a God-directed shooting spree because of the solar eclipse.
22-year-old Talon Nichelle Celestine of Georgia entered the highway 115 miles from the Alabama border in the Florida Panhandle and headed west. She then shot two drivers on Interstate 10 before being arrested and charged with attempted murder Monday, according to the Florida Highway Patrol. Lawrence Keller reporting.
Father journeyed to a place where Jesus came to teach one day. 16 miles down the road laid his dying son without much hope. The father begged, "Lord, come with me, heal my son from his disease." Then Jesus said, "Sir, go thy way, your dying son is healed today." His words as good as his touch. When he speaks, it means just as much. My faith or face to face. His words as good as his touch. Many years have come and gone since Jesus made this world his home. Though he's not here in the flesh, his spirit is with abundant grace. Blessed are those who have not seen, yet have the faith to believe. So cast all your cares on him. He can heal today like he did back then. His words as good as his touch. When he speaks, it means just as much. My faith or face to face. His words as good as his touch. Just as much, my faith or face to face. His words as good as his touch. Yes, his words as good as his touch. Mama used to wake up bright and early every day like it was Sunday morning, just to spend some quiet time with Jesus before the sound of little feet hit the floor. Sometimes I'd wake up and hear her singing an old hymn from years gone by. Precious memories of Mama every morning, and sometimes late into the night. Mama's prayers, I have no doubt, saved my life. One day Mama went to be with Jesus. She was carried away to Beulah Land, just to spend eternity in his presence. I can only imagine what she's doing now. Sometimes I'd wake up and hear her praying, singing an old hymn from years gone by. Precious memories of Mama every morning, and sometimes late into the night. Mama's prayers, I have no doubt, saved my life. She taught me all about John 3:16. And I was washed in the blood the moment I believed. Sometimes I'd wake up and hear her praying, or singing an old hymn from years gone by. Precious memories of Mama every morning, and sometimes late into the night. Mama's prayers, I have no doubt, saved my life. Mama's prayers, I have no doubt, saved my life.
Amen, amen. Well, that was Cindy Reynolds singing that well-written song by Jennifer Sides. Hallelujah. And I'll tell you what, beautifully written, beautifully sang, and it's just a wonderful song. So glad to be able to play it. Hey, we thank all of our artists out there, and I'll tell you, Brother Ed, Eddie Morvan's on here now, and him and his wife, Mary, they've written some beautiful songs as well, and sang, and I'll tell you, all of our artists out there today, we've got the cream of the crop, and I just want to praise God for that. They are blessed, highly favored, and because they are, we are too. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. Yes, Sister Jennifer, that's who wrote it. Amen. Believe it or not. Hallelujah. And God is a good God. Can somebody say amen? Hallelujah. God is good. Well, we're going to get back into the Word today here. We're going to take a little break, get back into the Word. And I hope y'all bear with me. We've been doing a study. I kind of broke off from it yesterday, but I want to get back in it today while we're still fresh and our minds are still fresh. And if you haven't been listening to it, you can go back and pick it up in the replays. We've been studying on the ministry gifts. And are you called? Are you called to be? And see, that's the question, you know. Are you called? Have you been called? Good morning, Brother Greg. Good to see you in here. I hope your eyes doing better. We've really been praying, had special prayer for you yesterday, and you will be on that list again today. I mean, that had to be something to go blind there for that period of time that you did. But thank God he's coming through and he's working. And I don't know if I could handle that myself, but all we could do is depend upon God, can't we? And he is the healer, the miracle worker. And just like that's what the positions and are the gifts of the Spirit, the gifts of ministry are. And see, they're not just pastor. They're not just evangelist. And I'm going to bring up the first two, talk about them for a minute, because a lot of folks, some places are saying that the days for that is over. But I guarantee you, the church age is not over. And as long as the church age is still here, the gifts of the apostle and the prophet are very much alive. People don't want to accept that because, well, it's just like, let me go on for a minute. And so are you called to be? Have you been called? Or did you just feel it one day and said, hey, I think I'm going to do this. So you just got up and went. You didn't even wait for a calling. You didn't know that God was calling you, blessing you, but you just got up and went. And I'll tell you, there's been a lot out there like that, and they fall flat on their face, and it ends up doing damage to the body. So we need to know that everyone that's been born again, you're not just chosen to sit in a pew, but you've just been chosen for ministry. Now, not everybody's chosen to be apostles. Not everybody's chosen to be prophets. Not everybody's chosen to be evangelists. Not everybody's chosen to be pastors. But there are other gifts, ministry gifts, that are just as important. Your helps, the gift of helps, the gift of governments. Come on, the gift of helps. What is that? Well, we've been talking about it. You could be the janitor. You could be the custodian. You could be, the one maintenance man. You could be the lawn service. You know, that those are helps to put things together. And, you know, it takes one person can't do it all. So if you've got a kitchen crew, you need others to help prepare the meal, help get it ready to be served, and so on and so forth. And you that have those gifts of feeding in your churches, that you're feeding the poor and feeding those that need help, and you feed every Friday, or you feed once a week, or you feed every day, or whatever. You need more than just one person to do it. You need cooks, you need dishwashers, you need preparers, you need people to go get the stuff. Come on and get the stuff. And if it's being purchased by a church, then you know you be responsible and get that done. And then everybody comes in and they puts it together. So it's the body working together. Some are chosen for songs. Some are chosen for just writing songs. Some are chosen to sing. Some are instrumentalist, amen, that God's given talents, and they're put and placed in a church. Now, listen to me a minute, because I've seen over my years and in my time, there are a lot of loose cannons out there. Now, what do I mean by loose cannons? There's people that go places that just because they don't get their way, or the pastor didn't shake their hand and say hi to them, they want to run off somewhere else. But when God places you and puts you in a place, you're there, amen, to fulfill his call to build that nucleus in that community that it will touch the people and bring souls in. We're all part of one body. Come on, hallelujah. And it just like there's so many people out there today, they'll work for a week at this job, then they don't like it or something happens, so they go over and work a week at this job, and they're always bouncing around. No stability, no commitment, come on, no faithfulness. But God says, and in the church, in the body of believers, he wants us dedicated, committed, and faithful. And so we wait upon our calling, and then we step out into our calling. And we've been talking about the apostle, and I want to finish the apostle up today on the last few articles of it. Amen. And then we're going to go over to the prophet, and then we're going to move into some of the other gifts as time allows us. But an apostle's got must have three biblical signs following his ministry. Number one, it'd be signs. Number two, wonders. And number three, mighty deeds. Those signs will follow if they're truly an apostle. An apostle never goes. He is always sent. He or she is always sent. And so the Greek word for apostle is apostolos, which means one who is sent forth. A sent one, not one that just got up and went, but one that is sent. And Christ himself filled that position in Hebrews 3:1. So, and before God places you in this position, you will have an experience, just like Paul did, had an experience with the Lord that is not traditional or ordinary. It's, amen, it's more above and beyond that. And it will be a very unique. It's not just an altar call. So you look at the example of Paul in Acts 9:36. He was an apostle. God called him, God ordained him, but look at his experience up to when he got called, how he got called, how non-traditional it was, and it nor was it ordinary. It was beyond the ordinary. So apostle is not a man taught. He is God called and God chosen and Holy Ghost prepared. No one could duly perform the office unless called by God. An apostle is not chosen by the judgment of men, but by the mouth and manifest oracle of the Lord himself. 1 Corinthians 9:1, and then Galatians 1:1. 11 through 12. Paul wasn't even taught by man. He was Holy Ghost taught. Come on, amen. So an apostle's ministry has served in all ministry gifts. Come on, he served in all ministry gifts, which enables him to be used of God to establish churches, to extend the work of the church, not take over or be voted in, nor is he hired. An apostle will be the founder. Come on, hallelujah. And an apostle will be able to step down and be the dishwasher. He will be able to be the maintenance man. He will be able to be the custodian. You know, he's not too proud, but he humbles himself and bends back to do that. So an apostle must also be able to provide adequate spiritual leadership. And this is not determined by his years in the ministry. It's determined by one's calling, and the anointing from God. So to be one, you must be anointed. In fact, in all the positions of ministry, there's an anointing that goes with it. And when we're anointed, say what? Yes, you have anointed cake bakers. You have anointed custodians. You have anointed people that God anoints to do those jobs, to fulfill them. Amen. And it gives glory to the Lord. And they work together. Come on. Regardless if you have a hindrance or a stumbling stone in the way one day, you just pick yourself up and you keep on going. That's called being faithful. Faithful consists of being committed, dedicated, and loyal. Come on. Just because the pastor didn't shake your hand that day, just because the pastor didn't recognize you in the crowd, doesn't mean you quit. You know, a lot of people do that. Well, he didn't ask me to sing, and I'm just going to go somewhere else. Come on. They move and are directed, and even the pastor is directed by the Spirit of God. And it's how the Spirit, well, God gave me a song, and I knew I was supposed to sing it. Well, if God didn't give it to him, and it wasn't in his spirit, if God had given it to him, he would have called you. If he didn't call you, God still may have given it to you, but it wasn't for that time. And your gift will always make room for you, and the time to deliver it will open up. So stay faithful. Don't get your feelings hurt and run off. Don't become one of the many loose cannons that are running out there. Stay committed, dedicated, and faithful. That's why God wants to build something. You're trying to build something in a city, in a place, and then everybody going different ways, doing different things, contention, division, fighting, and strife. It's not going to build anything. So we must realize that we are called by God, not by man, and then stay faithful to that. So he must be able to provide adequate spiritual leadership. And then once an apostle adequately establishes a church, he is ordained by God to exercise in the position as pastor, or God will have him turn it over to someone who is called to pastor. Amen. And I could go on and tell a story about that, but we're not going to talk about ourselves today. We're going to continue to talk about God. I know a person that doesn't like to call themselves apostle. They want to just be just who they are and be a person of God. But they have established, gotten now, and have three churches that they're establishing. And so that's what they're doing. They're establishing. They're working in the field of office. They work as can work as teacher. And they do many different things. They operate even in the gift of health. They're still young enough that they can do different things. Amen. And so they work in all the areas. Amen. But then now they have others that are stepping in, being called in, chosen and directed and called in to help with the work. Amen. So it's an awesome job. An apostle will always do the work of an evangelist. Always. They'll always do the work of an evangelist. What is the work of an evangelist? To get people saved. An apostle will always do the work of a teacher. Somebody said, well, what's the work of a teacher? It's to teach and establish people. And then an apostle will always do the work of a pastor. He will care for and nurture people. That's the job. Amen. And then once he has the work established, and God has someone there, a man that God has placed, and the apostle will know it. He'll know in his spirit, and the one that's there will know it. They will be step in and pastor the church. But the apostle doesn't give up his right to the church. He still has a right to it, and to be able to come in and minister and everything else, because, you know, and he might suggest to his pastor certain things. Well, that pastor being submitted to his authority, he is obedient, he is faithful, and he does what he's supposed to do. Can you see a pastor deciding, their overseer come in and saying, well, I'd like you to do this and I'd like you to think about this. You might do, yes, you're the pastor. You do what you want to do. But this is something I feel like what might be good for us if we do this. And a pastor said, you know, says, well, I don't like that. I'm going to go somewhere else. Yeah, that's nowhere near being faithful. And that's not the way God uses ministry. We've got to be committed. We've got to be loyal. And we've got to be faithful. Isaiah 60, 48, it says, but now, O Lord, thou art our Father. We are the clay, and thou art our potter, and we all do the work of thy hand. So together, we come together being faithful. And if you know God chose you, you know, and God placed you, you're going to stay and be firm regardless of what comes or goes, what might get in the way, what might be a stumbling block, whether somebody appreciates it or not. You're going to stay faithful to the commitment of the work of God in the area that God has placed you, and you won't become one of the loose cannons that are not willing to submit or settle down, but they just want to run around and they keep doing everything but being faithful and committed. And God's not happy with that. And in this day and in this hour, what God's beginning to do in the ecclesia, he's raising up a body of believers that are going to be interwoven, connected together, and powerful because they all are committed, dedicated, and faithful to the call where they are. And God's going to build those. And as he throws in the sickle to bring forth the harvest, there's going to be a house for them to come to. Amen. Hallelujah. They come. The church is the people, but the house is where we meet together, where we assemble together, where we get together, where we're fed, where we're taught, where we're nourished, where we're encouraged, where we're edified, where we're lifted up, where we get opportunity to use the giftings that God has given us. Amen. To build up, amen, a body that is a light to the world. Amen. We are that city set on a hill, and that city can't have division, dissension, or strife in it. It has to come together as one with the same mind, the same accord. Amen. Knowing if God, see, God calls us, God chooses us, God gives us our talents. Amen. There are people out there that can sing. I mean, they've got voices that just vibrate and just shake the heavens. Now, mine, I struggle, and I know that. But there's other things that I can do, amen, that God's blessed me in, and that I can handle and I can do. Amen. There's other people I play the piano. I can't play the piano. I've never done it. Amen. I can't play the piano, and I play at the guitar. Hallelujah. And there's other people that, I mean, they just pick that axe up and they go to town, you know, and I can't do that, but I can serve God. Amen. I can be there. I can have a shoulder. I can be a shoulder. I can have an ear to hear what the Spirit saith. I can listen to people with problems. Hey, and guess what? Amen. You know, there are folks out there that you can't tell everybody what's going on in your life because it'll be all over the 5 o'clock news. So you got to find who you can trust. But we're coming to a place where that body's coming together and everybody's going to work together. So let's look at a prophet now. And in 1 Corinthians 12 and 28 and Ephesians 4, 11, those are some scriptures for you that I don't feel I have time to read this morning, but you can look them up after it's over, or you can look them up while we're talking. Amen. And it's 1 Corinthians 12, 28 and Ephesians 4, 11. And a prophet, what does a prophet do? They say the day of the apostles is over, but it's not, because the church age is still here. We're still in the church age, and those gifts were given for the church, so the church could come together as a whole, come on, and be whole. And so a prophet, there's a simple prophecy, and then there is like Elijah the prophet, like Elisha the prophet, you know, like the prophets of the old, the major and the minor prophets, come on. But a prophet, he speaks by speaks by direct divine inspiration and immediate revelation. It's not something that's thought of, but it's something given at the spur of the moment by sudden operation of the Holy Ghost as spoken by God. They don't sit there and think about what they're going to prophesy. Well, let me see, what can I say in a church? But it's something that comes, that God chooses them, and it suddenly comes, and it begins to come forth and to be spoken. Amen. And so the person, they must be spiritually mature, must be a spiritually mature spokesperson, a proclaimer with a special divinely focused message to the church or the world. A prophet is uniquely gifted at times with insight of the past, present, or future events. And here in this last eclipse that we had, the solar eclipse, come on, there was a lot, I mean, prophecy in the solar eclipse, and God speaks to us about the signs and looking to the stars and that, and because he speaks to us through those things, not astrology, come on, but through those different things. And so this being and the signs of it, and you looked at it, amen, from the different things, the solar eclipse, God was speaking, amen. And there was some certain things that happened that were brought out of it. But look at all the that was being talked about, the failure, the world coming to an end, stock up on water, stay in your houses, make sure your cell phone, but you may have your cell phone knocked out. You may have this. Now we see on the news today some people that somehow they were touched and they went out and committed crimes because of the eclipse and blamed it on the eclipse. But there was a lot of prophecy that the world was coming to the end and so on and so forth. Well, it didn't come to the end. One day it's going to come to the end. It's not going to disappear and vanish away. But this world system as we know it, it's going to stop. And God's kingdom is going to take over and begin to rule. And so what they're prophesying. So now you know that those prophecies didn't come to pass, right? So you know that they're not true prophets or prophetesses. Come on, they're not, because God's prophecy will come to pass. It will happen. Amen. And so, but not all prophets, you know, you're not a prophet just because you prophesy. There's simple prophecy. Come on, that's kind of like in the church where you might know about somebody's and you're talking to them and prophecy, give them prophecy that encourages them. And there again, that should not be something that's thought of. It should come directly, immediately from God. And also, besides being in the full-time ministry, prophets should have a more consistent manifestation of at least two of the revelation gifts. That means revealing something. Two of those revelation gifts, gifts of the Holy Spirit operating in their lives, not an occasional, but consistent. And the three revelation gifts, amen. Now you wonder about that, must have at least two of them, amen. And just like the apostles and the prophets, they should not be involved that much in secular. Amen. Well, and we'll leave that alone for right now. We'll talk about that at another time. Amen. So at least two of the revelation gifts. And so let's talk about what the three revelation gifts are. Number one, is the word of knowledge. It's a supernatural revelation by the Spirit of God of facts in the mind of God concerning people, places, or things, always present or past. Come on, past tense, present or past tense. And this get, it's not a natural knowledge, and it's not knowledge of the Bible, it's not knowledge of God, but it's insight and understanding of circumstances, facts, without assistance of any human resource, but solely by divine aid, that must have a deep and advanced understanding of communicated acts of God. Prophets are not all knowing, but all telling. They'll tell what God has told them to tell. So you have an example of that in John 4:18 with Jesus and the Samaritan woman. And that was a beautiful story right there. We see a woman became the first evangelist. How about that? And all women ain't supposed to be in the ministry. Oh, yes, they are. Come on, you don't tell God who is and who ain't, because in him, there's neither man, male or female. Come on, we're all equal in God. Hallelujah. And so what happened there in John 4:18, it was the woman, Samaritan woman, the woman at the well. Remember? And she was living in sin. Come on, she'd been married 5 times and was living with a man, living in sin. And she was the talk of town. Everybody gabbed about her. Nobody liked her. Everybody run her down. Everybody said how evil she was. They had an attitude against her. And so she'd come out at noontime to the well to fetch water so that she didn't have to deal with it. She didn't have to listen to their ridicule and they're putting her down. And there she met Jesus. And what Jesus began to tell her about herself. And he told her, said, you've been married 5 times, and now you're living with someone and you're not married. And you're, you know, and he didn't put her down or point a finger at her or talk down to her. He just said, told her about herself. And she got so excited, you know, and told her about how she could be changed, how her life could be changed, that if she knew, she'd be asking him for the drink of water. And so all of a sudden she got so happy and excited, she ran into town. She ran into town and began to tell everybody, oh, come see a man who told me all about me, all about myself. And they came out, come on, and to get them to come out to see Jesus so that he could tell them about them too. But anyway, her life was changed. Her life was turned around. She'd met Jesus. Oh, and when you meet Jesus, he makes a difference. Come on. And so he told her, he had that revelation. He had the design, come on, knowledge. And God's prophets today, he gives them that same gift. Come on. So it's not because, now you've had a lot, I'll sit around and they'll hear, you know, hear a testimony service and somebody get up and say something, or they'll hear a prayer request. And then they'll call people out and say, well, God showed me you got this. Well, they done heard it in the testimony service. They done heard it in the prayer request. Hey, man, when I used to go out in evangelistic field, I wanted to be set back in the pastor's office. Amen. Till all that stuff was done. So when I come out and begin to minister, I could minister without having foreknowledge of what was going on in somebody's life. And God always worked. God always manifested. People were blessed. People's lives were touched. Amen. And then there's the word of wisdom. So we got the word of knowledge, the word of wisdom. And what is the word of wisdom? It's the supernatural revelation by the Spirit of God concerning the divine purpose in the mind and will of God. It always speaks of the future. This gift unveils in part not academic success, but supernatural perspective to ascertain the divine means of accomplishing God's will in given situations. They may have supernatural power divinely given by God to appropriate spiritual intervention in problem solving, sense of divine direction. This gift works interactively, often with the word of knowledge and discerning of spirits. Example, Joel 2 and 28. You can find a good example there. Write that down. Go in, search it. Joel prophesied God's spirit for the last days. Woo, hallelujah. Hey, and we are living in the last days for sure. Amen. And then you have the other, come on, which is the discerning of spirits. Number three, discerning of spirits. And it's the supernatural insight into the realm of the spirits. Seeing into the spirit realm. Discern, not the spirit of suspicion. Come on, where, you know, well, there's just something about them. No, this is a true anointed gift from God. It's the discerning of spirits. Come on. It's supernatural insight to the realm of spirits. Seeing into the spirit realm. Discern means to perceive by seeing or hearing into the spirit realm. It is discerning the spirit which motivates people. Is it good or evil? Being able to see and discern that spirit, what's motivating them, good or evil? Not the discernment of people's personalities. Come on, not judging or criticizing or being suspicious. A lot of people got the gift of suspicion, right? Thus, one has supernatural power to detect the realm of the spirits and their activities, which, but not limited to, the supernatural revelation of plans and purposes of the enemy and his forces. So there again, we see that in Acts. A good example of that to go back and read and look is Acts 13, 9 through 10. Acts 13, 9 through 10, where the sorcerer was speaking, and Paul rebuked it. Come on, rebuked him. Come on, because he realized that although they were saying those things, the intent of their heart was for evil and not for good. Amen. So a prophet will also have visions and revelations. He or she may speak forth his revelations through the gift of prophecy or by simply saying what the Holy Spirit says. He can foretell the future. An example of that was Agabus. He foretold the drought that was about to come in Acts 11 and 28. And Agabus foretold what would happen to Paul in Acts 21, 10, and 11. So there's some good examples of a prophet. Come on. And then we have prophetesses too, where women fill that position. The prophets are not to use this ministry for people to seek them out for guidance. Come on. He or she is to help the people to be led of the Spirit of God, Romans 8 and 14. And that's what we find in what's hurt the gift of prophecy in the church today. Amen. Is everybody is running to get a word. Oh, I got to get over. I hear somebody over there, they're prophesying. I got to get over there and get a word. I got to have a word. I got to have a word. This is our word right here. And any word that they give you should line up with the written word of God. And if it doesn't line up and come in line with it, then it's not from God. Yes, I said that. Amen. I know because I've been used in the office and I've seen it. That people will go from here to there chasing after different ones because they have to hear a word. My goodness, the Bible is full of words right there for them. And it's good if you're in a place and you can get that in your own church. If you have someone that has a gift operates in it and operates in it in the right form. God will bless, and you don't have to run somewhere else. Or if they get a word, it wasn't good enough for them. It wasn't what they wanted. So they run over here and get another word. So then that ain't good enough. They run over here to get another word. My goodness, when are God's people going to settle down, do some right thinking, and just accept what God has for them? I get word every day in the Bible. Come on, I don't need somebody to tell me. It's kind of nice when you get confirmation, but the word you get, God already have put it in your spirit. Come on, I've been in places where I didn't go. Somebody told me about a meeting or revival to go somewhere, and all of a sudden somebody called me up and they start giving me a word that is completely the opposite and contrary of anything God has ever revealed or taught me, totally against my spirit. So rather than make a scene or anything on that, I just tell myself, I refuse that, and then I walk out. And especially if the word they're given is contrary to God's word. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Woo, praise God. Come on. It's the truth is the truth is the truth. So we're not to use ministry to seek them out, people out for their guide or for guidance. He or she is to help the people to be led by the Spirit of God. Romans 8:14. She is not to control people with this ministry. And I've seen in churches where that gift is used to control their people. But hey, God's not happy with that. Amen. And that's changing with what God's doing today. He's tearing down those old things, and he's bringing forth the remnant in this ecclesia that's coming forth. Oh, hallelujah. In true worship, true anointing. Amen. And a harvest is about to be produced. And before anything else, a prophet should be either a teacher or a preacher of the word. No one is just a prophet. So if you're going to be a prophet, first you got to be a teacher or a preacher of the word. And then the laying on of hands goes with the prophet's ministry as well. A healing ministry is part of the prophet's ministry. A prophet should reject the notions of always having to have a word for people. You don't always have to have a word for people. You can lay hands on them. You can pray for them to be healed. Amen. And if God gives you a word while you're doing that, hey, that's fine. You don't have to always have a word for them. God does not tell a prophet everything. 2 Kings 4:27. 2 Kings 4:27. He doesn't always tell him everything. And so don't make up things just to satisfy or control people. A prophet speaks with forthrightness and insight, especially when enabled by the Spirit of God. Joel 2:28. Paul advised the prophets should be tested carefully. Come on. Let the prophets judge the prophets. Amen. And that was in 1 Thessalonians 5:19-21. 19-21. 1 Thessalonians 5:19-21. And then in 1 Corinthians 14:29-33. 1 Corinthians 29:33. Hallelujah. Amen. And then prophets can also confirm their spoken words from God through the performing of miracles. While some prophets like Moses, Exodus 4:1-9, he was a prophet, and Elijah, 1 Kings 17, they worked many miracles. And virtually all prophets occasionally see a miraculous fulfillment of God's word. And you find that in Isaiah 38:8. Isaiah 38:8. Hallelujah. Woo, praise God. Hallelujah. And then prophets also convey the word of God by writing. You can write. Amen. Isaiah 8 and 1 is an example of that. Isaiah was a prophet. Amen. Follow his life. You want to see what a prophet does? Look them up. Look up the prophets and see how God used them. See what they were called to do. Ezekiel 43 and 11. Ezekiel 43 and 11. Hallelujah. Praise God. And Jesus called himself a prophet. And that was Luke 13 and 33. He was also an apostle. He was a prophet. He was also the Savior. Come on. He was the Lamb of God. So his miracles and discernment were understood as prophetic. He had a prophetic ministry. Amen. And that's what's coming forth from today, from the ecclesia, is a prophetic, word of God and a move of God. And that is John 4 and 19. And he taught not by citing expert rabbis, but with his own prophetic authority. And you'll find that in Mark 1, 22 and Luke 4, 24. Hallelujah. Oh, praise God. Mark 1, 22 and Luke 4, 24. Prophets also predict. Acts 11, 28 and 20, 23. Acts 11, 28 and then 20, 23. They announce judgments. Acts 13, 1 through 2. Acts 13, 1 through 2. They Acts symbolically. Acts 21, 10 through 11. Acts 21, 10 through 11. And receive visions. Acts 9 and 10. Acts 9 and 10. 11 and 2. 11 and 2, 2 Corinthians 12 and 1. 2 Corinthians 12 and 1. Prophets use phrases such as the Lord says or the Holy Spirit says as an introduction for prophetic insight into the future. Acts 21 and 11. Acts 21 and 11. Amen. So now that we've covered the apostle and the prophets, the parts in the ministry, we're going to get into starting tomorrow. We'll be going into the ministry gifts according to the Bible of the pastor, the teacher, the evangelist, and the false prophet. And then after that, we'll get into the helps and the governments and so on and so forth. And see, we need to know this, church. We're a body. And the church has backed away from teaching this stuff so that people actually know, amen, what is supposed to be going on, what to be looking at, come on, and what lines up with God's word. And that all of us are called to ministry, maybe not a prophet, maybe not an apostle, maybe not a pastor, maybe not a teacher, but all of us were called. It could be in the gift of helps. It could be in music. It could be in singing. It could be in the choir. It could be, come on, it could be in the kitchen. It could be in the groundwork. It could be in the governments, you know. It could be making up flyers and doing things like that to help in those areas. That's ministry and gifts that God's given to us. If somebody's good at decorating, if you got a green thumb and your flowers and plants grow for you like nobody's business, and you're in a church, a local body, then maybe possibly your job and your part in ministry is to make sure that the plants and flowers around there are there because they're going to grow beautiful and they're going to be a blessing to people. And amen, when people come in, they're going to see the beauty of that. Amen. And it's going to give glory to God. Our gifts give glory to God, not to ourselves. we know a sister in amen in the Harvest Church that is so talented at baking and decorating what they do. Beautiful. And I'll tell you, it gives glory to God. It's awesome. It's a trait. She uses it for herself, but she also uses it in the church and for the church as well. And it's a blessing. It's beautiful. You have people like Brother Brown. He plays the pedal steel guitar. And I mean, he does a magnificent. I can't do that. And I'm not going to try to. Amen. But I step back out of the way and I'm not going to be jealous of him. I'm going to encourage him. I'm going to praise him. I'm going to tell him how beautiful the song sounded. Why? Now, I don't praise him over God, but what I'm saying, I encourage him. Amen. And give him honor. Amen. Because of the beautiness of the gift that God's placed in him. And he knows that that's what it is. And so there's all different parts of the body that work together to bless God. And if God's placed you in a body, yes, I know there is a season, but there's so many people said they'll be there a week. Oh, well, the season's over now. It's time for me to go somewhere. And they do that every. No, the season, don't quit using that as an excuse. Come on. When God places you somewhere, you stay committed. You stay faithful regardless. If you get looked over, if you get passed by, if you got a stumbling block in your way, if the pastor don't shake hands with you, if somebody at the church don't say hi to you, you just keep on keeping on, because you know when God places you somewhere, he places you there for that body to grow and to be blessed. And that is your home. Come on, give God some hand praise in the house today. Man, I know I've got my prayer list here and I want to get over to it right now. Amen. We're running out of time. Hallelujah. Yeah, we're running out of time. And I hope you're enjoying these lessons. And we're going to continue on, like I said, again, tomorrow and get in some of the other offices. We're going to cover everything. Amen. Because it's all what we need to know today. We have young baby Christians, amen, in places that are not sure. They don't know. They haven't been taught.
You can ask a question, my sister Tori.
They don't know anything. Oh, no. Sister Tori, the writings that you put in the chat room, you put in all you're doing is putting in the Word of God. You're putting that Word in God and sharing to others. And we have opened up our chat room for people to use their gifts. Come on. And so God has gifted you with the Word that you can bring it out and amen and put it in there. Please, by all means, share it. Amen. Because that's what our chat room is for. Just because I host the program doesn't mean I do everything. Come on. And just like in a church, just because somebody pastors don't mean they do everything. And everybody always wants them to do it all, or they expect them to do it all. But we that have the different gifts, come on, whether it's a gift of being able to share the Word, you've read the Word, you've shared it, you've got it in you, you put it out there. Amen. There's nothing wrong with that. And we actually thank you for doing that. Amen. Because everybody needs it. And you don't know who's sitting in this prayer room, in this chat room, or who's watching the program. Come on, and sitting back by that you put a Word in there, that Word may not be for me, and it may not be for Sister Linda. Come on, I'm not saying it ain't, but I'm just saying it may not be, but there's someone there that Word is going to speak to, and it's going to touch their heart and touch their life. You're not doing it for to exalt yourself. You're not doing it for vain reasoning. You're doing it there because God's put it on your heart and you put it in there. So please don't stop. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Because everybody enjoys the Word and we need to hear the Word. And just like in your churches, God's giving you gifts. Use those gifts and the pastor will open the door for you. He'll know when it's time. He'll know what you do. God will show him. He's not dumb. God will put it in his heart. He'll show him who's supposed to do what and who's not supposed to do, but just do it. And the words, the word of God say, with everything that you do, do it with all your might and do it as unto the Lord. So if you're doing it with the right reasons and you're doing it with all your might, and you're doing it unto the Lord, amen. Just put it out there. Put it out there, girl. Don't worry about it. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. How many of you say amen to that? You enjoy hearing the word. You enjoy seeing the word. Amen. When scripture comes in there, I mean, she didn't call out no names. This scripture is for you. She just put scripture in there. Amen. And that's what we have opened this chat room for, everyone that's here and part of this, to use your gifts. Amen. Now, if it's a song, I know you can't sing it because the chat room don't hear you. Amen. Hallelujah. But you can put an encouraging word in there. If God shows you that there's somebody in there today, sad and sorrowful, you can't see anybody's faces that you're watching other than their picture. Amen. And God says there's someone there today that you're really sad. But Jesus says, look up unto me, and put a scripture there where he says that to help with sadness. Amen. And there's nothing wrong with that. We want that. We promote that. Amen. Because you are part of the body as well. Amen. And you're an important part of the body. I hope that answered it. Okay. Amen. And we're going to move along to the prayer list. Amen. I know what you're saying, Sister Tori. Amen. But that's okay. And we couldn't hear you anyway, if you're singing in the chat room. Hallelujah. But you're all right. You're all right. Let's remember Brother Jerry and Rhonda Stevens. And there's about seven different people went with them down to that Nashville fire conference with Kent Christmas and Kent and Candy Christmas. And I'll tell you, Kent was on he was on the program last night, and I tell you, it was a blessing. It was mighty. It was anointed, and we wish we could be there too, but we were not this time. Maybe next time we'll get to go. Amen. It's going to be awesome. So him and about seven other people have gone. They're going to be there, so they need traveling graces, and God go with them and just be a blessing and touch their lives. Amen. And let's remember Sister Perrette, amen, that she gets a headache when she uses her eye drops. So God help her that stops and ceases, and that you just touch her, Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. And Lord, also remember Linda Strickland and her brother Bob for salvation and healing, God. And we thank you for the miracle that Sister Linda has received. Linda Strickland, and God just keep touching them, keep working with them, and her husband Leon. Let's remember Tracy Stone and Tim Fowler as they're out on the big rig, along with Tori's husband Jeff out on the big rig. For these folks out on the big rig, that God, you keep them safe and keep the shiny side up and the rubber side down. Be with them, God. Just make a way. Let things go smooth. And we know there's sometimes going to be complications, but God, you're in that. But don't let it affect or tear up their peace and joy in the Holy Ghost. And God, for health, touch Tracy's body. Touch Brother Tim in the name of Jesus. Let's remember Jana Bostic, amen, and her family, her sisters, her brother, her children, her grandchildren. And let's remember Chuck and Donna Bryant as well, Tori and Jeff. Let's remember Jackie L, Anna Short, but at that Sally Short, amen, let's remember her. I remember her as Sally, and Anna is her middle name, so we know who she is. Let's remember Jerry and Jama Park. Keep your hand upon them. It's going down. My leg brought into here. Let's remember Brother Mike. Let's remember Nathan Marshall, amen, for strength in his legs. And let's remember Brother Eddie, the left eye, and amen, a touch in his eye. Let's remember Greg Frederick, amen, for his eye and what's going on in his body right there. Let's pray for all of our gospel artists. Amen. That God touch them, touch their families. And let's pray for all the prodigals to come in. Amen. And we got scriptures we're going to be sharing with that one day soon and very soon about how God's promised. So we don't have to worry about it. Let's remember prayers for the WOTG, KOTG radio DJs, all the WOTG TV ministries. Amen. For each and every one of them and the networks, that God will continue to move and to bless us. Remember, lift up everybody here today on the radio as well. Come on, that are listening. They haven't been able. Yes, Sister Sandra, we mentioned you. You pray for you and for what you're going through and your eye and the eye drops and the headache. Amen. And your life and all that, that God would continue to work it out and give you the direction and guidance to take care of what you need to take care of. Do your part. Amen. Hallelujah. As we all must do our part as well. Come on. And that we all are obedient to God, obedient to his word. So let's pray for all the needs today. Amen. As we lift them up, Sister Lois Kears, Sister Elaine Batchelor, Steve, that he get his job done. Hallelujah. That material's been held up, but God, you can deliver it, get it set free. And for Eddie and Mary Morvant, God, and just everybody today, God, everyone here in the chat room, everyone, God, listening on the radio, and all that we know, God, and your complete body, just move with a special touch and a special anointing to all. So if you'll reach over and touch, amen, hallelujah. Ooh, praise God. That's right. Anyone that needs a special touch from the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Sister Tori. Yes, and you as well. And me as well. And Sister Linda as well. We all need prayer. We're not anybody special. We're human just like everybody else. We're still in this human tent. So we all have needs. Yes. Good afternoon, Sister Lois Cares. You're just in time for prayer. And we'll pray for Sister Lois as well. Amen. Hallelujah. Father God, right now, in the name of Jesus, as we reach over and touch this device as a point of faith contact only, there's no magic in it. It's a point of faith contact, which means we're coming. You're according to your word, where you said, if any two agree on touching one thing, it shall be done. So together we're joining hands. We're praying a corporate prayer for all the needs of all the people on the radio, in this program, each and every individual, God, all that we know, all of our, God, artists, singing artists, songwriters, God, all of your body right now, God, every part, every nucleus of your body today, in the different parts, that God, you just rain down a special anointing and power today as you're restoring unto you the, oh, hallelujah, right now, God, amen, the Spirit's going forth, it's beginning to rain, oh, hallelujah, people are receiving things that they don't even know, and they'll discover it here shortly. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for this mighty move. Continue to work, continue to lift up, continue to heal, continue to deliver, continue to set free. God, continue to restore. God, oh, hallelujah, provide everything that we need. Your word has said that you've given us everything that we need pertaining to life and godliness. We receive that word right now, and we say thank you and amen. We receive healing. We receive deliverance. We receive restoration in the name of Jesus. And everything that's been stolen, the enemy has been caught, and he has to return it sevenfold in the name of Jesus. We decree it now, and we call it done. And the church say, amen and amen. Come on, give him some praise up in the house here today. Hallelujah. We're going to go ahead and get this music started. Somebody's got a testimony, put it in the chat room. Let us know how God's moving for you. Well, we got two news reports right back to back. I may click one of them off, but let's go ahead and get started.
A woman checked out of a Florida hotel and told staff that she was going on a God-directed shooting spree because of the solar eclipse.
22-year-old Taylon.
This
Michelle
is News
Celestine
in 60 with Alan Edwards.
A woman checked out of a Florida hotel and told staff that she was going on a God-directed shooting spree because of the solar eclipse.
22-year-old Taylon Michelle Celestine of Georgia shot two drivers on Interstate 10 before being arrested and charged with attempted murder Monday.
Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu announced there is a date for Israeli defense forces to invade Rafah.
This is a move the United States opposes.
Federal charges have been filed against a 35-year-old man who allegedly set fire to the door of Senator Bernie Sanders's office in Burlington, Vermont.
Shant Sagamonian, formerly of Northridge, California, was arrested after investigators reviewed surveillance camera footage.
A suburban Detroit police officer who punched a young black man in the face and slammed his head to the ground pleaded guilty Monday to a federal civil rights violation.
Matthew Rodriguez acknowledged using unreasonable force against the 19-year-old man while processing him in the fingerprint room at the Warren Jail in June.
Storms of life, all other things have failed. With faith and trust in Jesus, His will to prevail. Believe that He can change your life, He'll hear your earnest plea. With your heart bowed to Jesus, He will meet your every need. Prayer changes things. Prayer changes things. When all else is failing, prayer changes things. Prayer changes things. Prayer changes things. When all else is failing, remember prayer changes things. I have called on Jesus, a valley in my life. I testify of what He's done. Today I am alive, 'cause He's alive. I'm doing well. I'm healed. He answered prayer. New life begins right here today, for He's alive and well. If you have trouble in your life, help from my God you need. Just like I have called on Jesus to meet my every need. You can do the same right here today. Trust and believe, you'll see. Your faith will lead to miracles. Just look around, you'll see. Changes things. When all else is failing, prayer changes things. Prayer changes things. Prayer changes things. When all else is failing, remember prayer changes things.
fading. Remember, prayer changes. God always knows just what we need. He can turn everything around unexpectedly. When we've given our all and think it's over and done, He makes a way where there just wasn't one. Life is great and getting better. Every day His grace shines through the stormy weather. Got my family and friends, and when you put it all together, life is great and getting better. He works all things together for our good. Even when we don't understand or act like we should. Troubles and trials come along every day. And all things considered, friends, I'd have to say that life is great and getting better. Every day His grace shines through the stormy weather. Got my family and friends, and when you put it all together, life is great and getting better. My mood and attitude are in my control. I'm choosing to use all the joy that's in my soul. Life is great and getting better. Every day His grace shines through the stormy weather. Got my family and friends, and when you put it all together, life is great, life is great, and getting better. Every day His grace shines through the stormy weather. Got my family and friends, and when you put it all together, life is great, getting better. Life is great, and getting better.
Took a burning bush, but Moses finally saw the light. A blinding bolt of lightning in the middle of the night. God said, get on down to Egypt. Old Pharaoh needs to know. He ain't gonna be happy if he don't let my people go.
God is in control, and that's the way it's always been. He's gonna free His children if it takes a blade of tin. No Pharaoh king or anything can stand against His might. God is on your side, and He ain't never lost a fight.
Shadrach and those other two are walking in a fire. Dealing with the Son of God as the flames grew higher and higher. They could not burn those men of faith, could not melt their hope. They walked right out of that fiery furnace without a smell of smoke.
God is in control, and that's the way it's always been. He's gonna free His children if it takes a blade of tin. No Pharaoh king or anything can stand against His might. God is on your side, and He ain't ever lost a fight.
No Pharaoh king or anything can stand against His might.
God is in control, and He ain't never lost a fight.
Yeah.
never lost a fight.
Oh, he ain't never lost a fight.
He ain't never lost a fight.
Never lost a fight.
He ain't never lost a fight.
Hey, y'all, this is Tanya Rose, and you are listening to the finest Southern gospel music there is. Don't you go nowhere.
Like the ancient Roman Empire, this world is doomed to fall. And it's much too big a thing for mortal man. Just take a look around and see the writings on the wall. Somehow we've got to find a helping hand.
This world has never been in the awful shape it seems.
Our leaders seem in doubt just what to do.
Yes, I'm a prayer was spoken from the heart of every man.
Jesus, take a hold and lead us through. The mighty roar of gunfire is now a local sound. Our city streets are filled with angry men. Law is but a mockery throughout our troubled land. And destruction seems to be the current trend.
This world has never been in the awful shape it seems.
Our leaders seem in doubt just what to do.
Yes, I'm a prayer was spoken from the heart of every man.
Oh, Jesus, take a home and lead us through.
This world has never been in the awful shape it seems.
Our leaders seem in doubt just what to do.
Yes, I'm a prayer was spoken from the heart of every man.
Jesus, take a home and lead us through.
If my people, which are called by my name, shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven, will forgive their sins, and will heal their land.
Jesus, take a home and lead us through.
Well, have you been blessed? We pray you have been encouraged by breaking of the bread and the washing of water by the Word of God, brought to you through the spoken word and song. You have been listening to the Pastor Jack Triple Hour with Pastor Jack and Linda Gale here on KOTG, KBAF, and Bayou Gospel Radio, all part of the WOTG Radio and Television Network. Our mailing address is Bethel Dimple, KOTG, Post Office Box 241, Atoka, Oklahoma, 74525. Remember, we are here every Monday through Friday from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. Central Standard Time. We invite you to share this program with others or host a watch party for your friends. If you feel led to do more, please feel free to contact Pastor Jack or Linda Gale, and they will tell you how you can be a part of this valid ministry. Or you can donate to this ministry electronically by going to paypal.me/Bethel950. That's capital B-E-T-H-E-L 950. Or mail your donation to Bethel Temple, KOTG,
Post Office Box 241, Atoka, Oklahoma 74525. Remember, let Christ be seen in you. No better testimony than standing strong in Christ, even in the storms.
If I wake up through the night for the break of daylight, I'm gonna praise, praise the Lord. Every morning, noon, and night, I'm gonna praise the Lord. I'm gonna praise the Lord.
Everyone for being here today. Thank you for your loyalty. Thank you for your faithfulness. Thank you for your input. Hey, God richly bless you. We will return again tomorrow morning at 8 a.m. with Women of Faith, Linda Gale, and then at 10 a.m. Captain Jack Show, Argmady, right here on the KOTG WOTG Radio Network and the WOTG TV Network. Until tomorrow, God richly bless you and keep you. Bye now.